Oh, yeah, I'm late. Late, late, late. A very important date. Yes, I am coming on. Happy Festivus, everybody. Welcome to the Christmas show. Here's how I feel. Christmas songs, but how can you not on December 23rd? That was written in 1950 for a Bob Hope movie called The Lemon Drop Kid. And that was filmed on a street scene of Bob Hope and Marilyn Maxwell. Walking down the street scene, ringing bells and taking money from from Santa's collection pots and giving it over to little kids. And well, lots of fun. It was a cute little scene. The Lemon Drop Kid. Written by Jay Livingston and Ray Evans. Jay Livingston wrote a bunch of very popular songs. Can't read, even read my notes here. Que Sera Sera, he wrote that. Mona Lisa, he wrote the theme songs for Bonanza and Mr. Ed, and he even sang Horses, a Horse, of Course, of Course. I don't know if he did the I am Mr. Ed part, but I just did. Thanks, yeah. Mr. Ed and Christmas, what goes together better? I don't know, but Silver Bells, being downtown and at Christmas time, and you know, always makes me kind of think of this song. Help, I know.
walk pretty, how can you lose? The night's so much brighter there. You can forget all your troubles, forget all your cares, and go downtown. Things will be great when you're downtown. You'll find a place for sure downtown. Everything's waiting.
That was actually the second charting hit of the British Invasion. We think of the British Invasion, we think of the Kinks and the Beatles and the Stones and the Who, and how often do we think of Petula Clark and Dusty Springfield and the women. But, you know, gotta love the women. Just as Jay Livingston wrote Silver Bells while walking around, listening to the bells and watching the Salvation Army Santas and everything, Tony Hatch, the British songwriter, wrote Downtown while walking around in Times Square. So there you go. I'll talk a little bit about what day it is once I check my thing. My recording device. Alrighty. Hey, the usual gang of idiots. Wishing me a happy birthday. Thank you ever so much. Yeah. Doing a lot of 60s songs today because 60 is on my mind because tomorrow, my birthday, I'll be entering my last year in my 60s. So I was on the move. How about that? But a lot of songs from the 60s, which I hope you will enjoy. I have no business doing them, of course. Anyway, welcome once again to episode 139 of the House Arrest Concert Series, live from Mount Laurel, New Jersey, with me, your host and sole performer, Bill Spence. Today is the third day of Yule. It is Festivus, which was actually invented in 1966 by a guy named Daniel O'Keefe, who was an editor for Reader's Digest. His son, Dan O'Keefe, was a writer for Seinfeld. And that's how that idea got to be on the show with Jerry Stiller and airing his grievances. I got no grievances to air because I'm the only one in the household, so enjoy Festivus, everybody. Today's also National Roots Day, where people are encouraged to look up their roots. I've been doing that on and off for the past few months and kind of retracing a lot of the work my brother Richard did years ago that traced our ancestry back to some very important people on my mom's side. And I won't brag, William the Conqueror. But anyway, it's a lot of fun to check on your roots. Finally, it is also National Pfeffernuss Day. Pfeffernuss is a nutty, spicy German cookie. sometimes they're a stretch, you know, a couple days before Christmas. Well, you know, tomorrow's Christmas Eve, the day after is Christmas. But what do you got for today? Pfeffernuss and roots and Festivus. It's also Susan Lucci's 77th birthday. Disgraced television executive Les Moonves's 75th birthday, and Simpsons performer, and Derek Smalls, and This Is Spinal Tap, Harry Shearer is 80 today. This day in history. In 1972, Franco Harris made the immaculate reception. It was a tipped-off pass from Terry Bradshaw. And 1959, Chuck Berry was arrested for violating the Mann Act, which is transporting minors across state lines for immoral purposes. He somehow gave a ride to a 14-year-old. Yeah. In 1888, Vincent van Gogh cut off his ear. Actually, it was just the earlobe. And he gave it to a nurse, not a girlfriend. That was 2 years before he tragically shot himself. He suffered from depression most of his life and sold only one painting before he died. But now, of course, he's legendary. And, what are you going to do? You suffer from depression, you do lots of things. You cut off your ear, you might go downtown. I took my troubles down the mad roof. You know that gypsy with a gold cap tooth. She's got a pad down on 34th and Vine. Selling little bottles of love potion number 9. Told her that I was a flop with chicks. Been that way since 1956. She looked at my palm and she made a magic sign. She said, "What you need, son, is love potion number 9. Potion number 9. I held my nose, I closed my eyes, I took a drink. I didn't Two times on the chart. First in 1959, it hit number 23 by a band called The Clovers. And number three in 1964 by The Searchers, written by Jerry Lieber and Mike Stoller, who wrote over 70 hits between them. You know, you know some of them. I can't look it up. That'll be your YouTube, Wikipedia assignment for the week. Because I can't remember and I didn't write it down because my notes take up all the page here. So, to carry on with the Van Gogh depression, another fellow with a familiar name. His name was actually Raymond Edward O'Sullivan. And number one, actually, in 1972. In a little while from now, if I'm not feeling any less sour, I promise myself I'll treat myself and visit a nearby tower. Myself off in an effort to make it clear to everyone. It's like when the shadow left standing in the lurch at a church with people saying, my God, that stuff should stir them up. No point in us remaining. We may as well go home as I did on my own, alone again, naturally. Bright and gay, looking forward to what I wouldn't do, the role I was about to play. As if to knock me down, reality came around, and without so much as a mere touch, cut me into little pieces, leaving me to doubt. Talk about God and His mercy. hit number five with this song. Let's see if I can do this. J. Thomas in 1969, and again in 1974, a number one hit for Blue Swede. That was the Oonga Chaka version, which I'm sure we all remember. But I didn't want to play. It's written by a guy named Mark James, who wrote a couple of big songs, Suspicious Minds. And You Were Always on My Mind. Hooked on a Feeling. From, 1969 and 1974. Talked about the British invasion. And, this woman's manager. Reached out to the writer of this song and said, hey, I want something to put her on the charts. And this, not Downtown, was actually the second hit of the British invasion. Hit number 12 in 1964. The second after I Want to Hold Your Hand. But there are 100 versions of this song written, and you know, or recorded, but this one I like.
Can't you see? Whatever. forces we make that hold on me. It happens to be true. Show tonight. I've got a bunch of things I want to do. This is one of them. And from 1967, this was a number 22 hit. Came from the soundtrack of the James Bond spoof movie Casino Royale. It actually was nominated for an Oscar in 1968. It was first done instrumentally by Stan Getz in 1966, but in 1967, Dusty Springfield once again took it to number 22.
Feel my arms around you.
can hardly wait to hold you, feel my arms around you. How long I've waited, waited just to love you. Now that I've found you, don't ever go.
And a 1967 number one song out of Tupelo, Mississippi. Well, various places in Mississippi.
Billy Joe was throwing something off the Tallahatchie Bridge. Four in Tupelo. And then that COVID came around, Bob McCullough, and he died last spring. And now Mama doesn't seem to want to do much of anything. And me, I spend a lot of time picking flowers up on Choctaw Ridge and drop them in. What an awful Tallahatchie bridge.
Bob Gentry called that a study in unconscious cruelty. I don't know one of mine. Which you might like. And coming up on 45 minutes, that's long enough. Thank you to all of you who stayed with me. Nice and cold. Enjoy your Christmas with your family and friends. And this is one of my favorite Christmas songs. Have yourself on December 23rd. Thanks once again for joining me until next time, which will probably be next year. I don't think I have enough in me to do a New Year's party. But who knows? Maybe I'll have an invitation to go somewhere. Who knows? Anyway, enjoy your holidays and ciao, ciao. This to Facebook and housearrestconcert.com. Happy 2024, everybody. Ciao, ciao. Whoa. Thanks for all the lovely comments, and that'll finish it up for now.